yarns and a little bit on weaving with the one that's on the loom at the moment. The yarns that I've been working with plant dyes. There's a little bit of handspun yarn and then mostly commercial pure wool yarns and a couple of yarns that I just had in the box. I'm not sure what content of or what kinds of wool they are. So I've been dyeing them with onion skins and I've got lots of different colours and shades. These are going to go into weavings. I like really earthy colours. There's a part in this video of me dyeing the yarns. I'm working on a set of tutorials that will be available over the internet and one of them is going to be on creative yarn dyeing. Do remember to subscribe and click the notification bell if you'd like to know when our next videos come out. And if you click the like button on the video, it really helps the video to be seen by others, so thank you. This is the fleece that I washed in a video quite recently. It's a Leicester long wool and it's lovely grey curls. There's bits of browns and different colours in there as well. This is our wool picker. It was built by Paul Britton. He's a classic carder and it's a swinging wool picker. And what it does is once I've washed the fleeces, then I put them through this wool picker and these tines on the top and the tines on the bottom pull the fleece open so it's ready to card on the drum carder or hand carders so that it doesn't break the pins on the carders. So it's got really strong tines, they're sharp, not to touch but they would if they got caught on me. So I use protective gloves when I'm working with it. I'm going to pick this one open so that I can spin straight from the fleece. I'm not going to card it. It's going to be really pretty spun into a yarn straight from being picked, because it'll still have lots of curl and texture in it. If it's too short a staple, then I'll card it like I did with Hazel's fleece in the last video. I had to card that one.